Everyone, so let's start with the Anatomy MCQ Marathon, second part, targeting NEET PG 2021. Myself, Dr. Mona Lisa, educator of anatomy subject on the platform of Unacademy. So I have got a total of 8 years of teaching experience and done my MD anatomy from Armed Force Medical College, Pune. So let's start with the session now. So before starting the session, meanwhile, everyone is joining. I would like to give you a brief introduction about the platform of Unacademy. So let's see. So this is my unlock code, which can be used by you for taking the subscription of Unacademy and for watching free sessions on the Unacademy platform. This is my Telegram group, Mona Lisa Anatomy. Do join this for the links of all my free sessions and also update of all my plus course and sessions coming up. And also updates and anatomy related doubts will be cleared here. Okay. So now I also want to tell you the plan which I have scheduled. Actually, for the coming your examination, till your exam, I will take many free sessions targeting NEET PG examination. So it will be more of MCQ kind of thing, which will have a revision. So all of you join for the revision of anatomy MCQs there. And today 8 p.m. and again 9 p.m. session is there. All the sessions are of 40 minutes only. And in 18th July, that is tomorrow, the morning 10 a.m., then 11, then 12 and 1. So these are the session details. Do join there. And the updates and the links of my session will be shared on the Telegram group of mine, Mona Lisa Anatomy, and also on the platform of Unacademy. And let's crack NEET PG platform. Okay. So this is the unlock code ANAT10, which can be used for those students who are using or seeing the session for the first time, and also for taking the plus subscription. So let me give you an idea about the plus subscription and what are the benefits. So if you are want to take the plus subscription, and if you go for the iconic subscription, that is a merging of the Prep Ladder and Unacademy, so you can use this code ANAT10 for 10% discount, and these are the discounted rate of the iconic subscription. To do go for it. And I would also like to tell how you are going to take the subscription and be the part of free session. Download the Unacademy app from the Play Store and then find your goal as NEET PG. Thereafter, you have to find your educators whom you want to follow or you want to see the free sessions. And also for taking the plus subscription, use the code ANAT10. Okay, thereafter you can go for plus subscription. What are the benefits of plus subscription? If we compare the benefits of plus subscription weightage on the special free session, special free sessions is given by the platform of Unacademy, it's highly useful, but the thing is that it is not in a structured form. Okay, you can't get the entire course free, but on the plus subscription, daily life sessions are there, structured courses targeting a particular examination, whether it is the NEET PG, whether it is INICT, whether it is FMG, whether it is a prof examination, whether it is next. So this is in a targeted form and with no gaps, continuously the session is taking. And the other positive point about the plus subscription is that for each and every subject, more than 3-4 educators are there, 4-5 educators for a single subject. So you can follow any of these courses and classes. And also the benefit is that you will get the PDF of the notes. Every fourth session is a doubt clearing session on the Plus platform. Live tests and quizzes are there. Unlimited sessions are there. So you can be the part of unlimited. If you are not able to attend the Plus live class anytime, you can view that session number of times. No limitation is there. Use the code ANAT10 for additional 10% discount. My dear students, you can go for iconic subscription, which is extremely beneficial because it is merging the benefits of the live sessions of Unacademy along with the Prep Ladder. Okay, so in this category of iconic subscription, you get printed notes. Okay. Printed notes will be shipped to your location. Okay, it will be sent. And video lectures, QBank 3 of the Prep Ladder can be assessed, rapid revision courses, also live test quizzes, and all the benefits of plus subscription, having the live interaction with the top educators along the class. These all benefits will be added on, and all these benefits are included in the iconic subscription. So what I suggest, do go for iconic subscription. Use my code and add 10 for 10% discount. Now, these are the comparison of the rates of iconic with the plus. So you can go through it, and the rates are quite low. You can use my code ANAT10, which will give you additional 10% discount. Also, I want to tell you about 4-year subscription, which is extremely beneficial for the first year students and the second year students who want to prepare for their university exam. So in this entire 4 years of duration, the benefit is that you will not only be supported for your university exam, the theory papers, the practical papers by the top educators on the Unacademy platform, but also the target is to complete the next. And this next will not only give you the clearance of your to go to the internship, but also if you just pass it in a good rank, you will get your desired PG seats. Okay, that is the dream goal of all the students. So you can go for plus subscription, take 4 years of subscription. The rates are quite low. Plus ke liye 60,000 and for Iconic 75,000. Use this code for additional 10% discount. That is ANAD10. Now these are the 2 month subscription, 6,550 introduced for NEET PG aspirants, and boost your medical preparation taking 12 months of subscription and getting additional 2 months absolutely free. Okay, these are the batches. So I would like to give you brief about my own batch, which is coming from the 21st July. Interested student can take the subscription. If you are interested only for these batch, then you can take the subscription of either 6 month, and you can also have a EMI to pay this subscription. And a whole of the anatomy is taken by me along with the other top educators of Unacademy platform. All the first year course is completed in this batch along with second and third year. So you can take the subscription, can prepare for next and university exam. So just go for it. ANAD10 is the code, and additional 10% discount you will get. Other batches which is coming up is the last mile NEET PG preparation, integrated clinical batches by the top educators of Unacademy platform, integrated clinical batch for NEET PG 2021. So whichever suits you, go for it. All the best to everyone. And Focus FMG batch and Target Next 2022 batch. So these are the batches which is coming up simultaneously running on the platform of Plus. Go for it and use my code ANAD10 for additional 10% discount. Let's start. All the best to everyone. Let's start with the session now. What is today's goal is to complete as much as revision of MCQs can be done, so that all of you target the MCQs, because it is important that previous year ke MCQs, yeah, those important points should not be missed out. So let's complete it. Coming to the first MCQ, mark ligament is attached to which of the following structure except. So you will get 15 seconds to answer. Let's start with this. So mark your correct answer. Question number one. Identify the ligament and then tell me it is not attached to which of the following. Question number one. Mark ligament is attached to all of the following except, not attached to which of the following structures. So I got 24% students have marked the answer right. And the correct answer here is question number one is medial cuneiform. My dear friends, which is this ligament? This is medial ankle ligament. This ligament is medial ankle ligament. I would like to show you a diagram. Yes, absolutely right. It's the deltoid ligament. The other name of this ligament is deltoid ligament. So D is absolutely right. I would like to show you a diagram where you can appreciate the attachment of deltoid ligament. So let's see here. Okay, now what you can see, this is the medial ankle ligament. And my dear friends, medial ankle ligament upper attachment is similar. It is on to MM. What is MM? Medial malleolus of tibia. Upper attachment jo hai, medial ankle ligament ka, it is attached onto the medial malleolus of the tibia bone. That is lower end of the tibia. From here, four slips. From here, four slips are arising. And these four slips of medial ankle ligament or deltoid ligament is attached to following bones. As you can see, it is attached to the talus bone posteriorly. Posterior tibiotalar anteriorly, posterior anterior tibiotalar, and also it is merged with the spring ligament that is also called as plantar calcaneo-navicular ligament. This is spring ligament. Okay, so can you see here, this part of the ligament is merging with this. This is spring ligament, so it is also attached to the spring ligament. And my dear friends, what you can appreciate is also attached here to the navicular bone. So this is navicular bone, this is the calcaneum bone, and it is also attached to the calcaneum bone. So what you can appreciate, it is attached to heel bone, calcaneum bone, spring ligament, navicular bone, and the talus bone. But in this diagram, what can be appreciated, it is not attached to any kind of cuneiform bone. So the correct answer is A. Everyone, is it okay? Let's move on to the second MCQ. Okay, marked structure is a guide to which nerve? So firstly, you have to identify the marked muscle tendon and you have to tell me which nerve is it guiding. The location of these structure is guiding to which nerve? Your time starts now. Please mark the correct answer. So yes, approximately 42% of the students are absolutely correct, and the correct answer is medial nerve. The first thing which I want to explain you that which is this muscle tendon. So if you clearly see, can you appreciate this is the muscle tendon, and when it is approaching to the palmar aspect of the hand, what you can appreciate? It is diverging. Everyone, can you appreciate it is diverging? As you can see, it is becoming flattened and this is forming palmar aponeurosis. It is forming the hand aponeurosis. Okay, it is forming the aponeurosis. Palm ke upar ye aponeurosis banata hai. So this is flattened tendon of palmaris longus muscle. So the correct answer is median nerve. It forms a flattened tendon of palmaris longus muscle. The correct answer is median nerve. Now let me show you here another diagram. So can everybody appreciate what is this PL? This is palmaris longus muscle. This is palmaris longus muscle. And when this palmaris longus muscle is approaching here, everyone. So see here, I have highlighted this tendon. This is palmaris longus muscle. And here it is written PA. It is forming palmar aponeurosis. Everyone, can you appreciate that if you know the structures forming superficial to flexor retaniculum? My next question to you is that कि palmaris longus का tendon is passing superficial to flexor retaniculum or deep to flexor retaniculum? Everyone, can anybody tell me palmaris longus tendon passes superficial or deep to flexor retaniculum? Please give me the answer. Yes, absolutely right. So I'm getting answer superficial. Absolutely right. Most of you are absolutely right. Yes, students, absolutely right. And which structure is passing deep to flexor retaniculum? Median nerve. Can you see here MN is written? I am using yellow color for it. See here, everyone, I am using yellow color for it. And this yellow color structure which you are seeing is the median nerve. So median nerve is passing deep to flexor retaniculum. So we have got location of palmaris longus tendon as marking the location of median nerve. So yes, the correct answer will be median nerve. So in this case, the correct answer will be median nerve. Got it, everyone? Let's move on to the third MCQ. So let's move on to the third MCQ. Yeah, posterior boundary of highlighted triangular space. So you have to identify this blue color triangular space. Which triangular space is this? And then you have to tell me the correct answer. Posterior boundary of highlighted triangular space is superior belly of omohyoid, posterior belly of digastric, sternohyoid, and sternocleidomastoid muscle. Question number three, please mark the correct answer. Okay, great, great. Many of the students has given the right answer. Okay. So yes, many of the students has given the right answer, approximately 79%. Yes, approximately the correct answer is sternocleidomastoid. Can anybody tell me which triangular space is this? Which triangle is this? Which triangle is this? Which is shown in the diagram? Yeah, absolutely right. This is carotid triangle. Yes, carotid triangle. And we clearly know that posterior boundary of carotid triangle is formed by sternocleidomastoid muscle. SCM, sternocleidomastoid muscle. So I have included this diagram. Please do revise, all of you. It's a very important topic for your NEET PG21, for your next examination, for your university examination, for your AIMS, INICT examination. Contents of all triangle. All triangle means suboccipital triangle, skeleno-vertebral triangle, carotid triangle, digastric triangle, okay, submental triangle, muscular triangle, and see the continuation of the structure passing from one triangular space to other. So yes, those who have missed out can see my session of triangles of neck. I have already taken this session. Now, my dear friends, this blue color triangular space is carotid triangle, and it is bounded by following structures. So this is sternocleidomastoid muscle, and it is bounded by the posterior belly of digastric, posterior belly of digastric and that of stylohyoid muscle. And on the inferior aspect, it is bounded by superior belly of omohyoid. And why it is called as carotid triangle? The reason is that it is containing carotid, all types of carotid arteries. Okay, it is containing the common carotid artery, internal carotid artery, external carotid artery, along with its covering, that is carotid sheath, which is also having vagus nerve and internal jugular vein. Absolutely right. Let's move on to the next MCQ. Question number four. A 37-year-old pregnant woman is given caudal epidural block to alleviate the pain during the vaginal delivery. Caudal epidural blocks involves injection of local anesthetics given in the sacral canal. So this is a clinical question. Which of the following landmark is most commonly used for caudal epidural block? Okay. Caudal epidural block for having painless delivery. Okay, painless vaginal delivery ke liye hum epidural block karte hai. So kaun sa hamara bony landmark hai which is used for giving this anesthesia? So your time starts now. Please mark the correct answer. We have got five options. Bony landmark. Your time starts now. So yes, we have got 29% of the students are correct. Okay, Manish Kumar is leading grade one. So welcome Manish, Nandini as I'm grade one. So at the end, I will show you the leaderboard. Okay, good performance. Okay, yeah. So the correct answer is sacral hiatus ke corona. Actually, when you will see the sacral opening, so it is introduced inside when the needle is penetrated inside, we have to feel a bony prominence. So actually, on either side of the sacral hiatus, there is the corona of the sacral hiatus, which is called as the bony prominence, and it will help you to guide and to reach the space of epidural space. Okay, so that is the corona of sacral hiatus. I would like to show you a diagram which will give you a clear picture of it. Okay, so anterior sacral, posterior sacral foramina, why to go in the sacral foramina to keep the epidural block? No reason. It is lying on the either aspect. We are not moving there. Intervertebral foramen, this is also not approached. And also the medial sacral crest is a bony prominence above proximally, so it has not to be approached. Which structure has to be approached is the sacral hiatus corona. So everyone, can you see here the epidural block has to be performed? The needle is introduced and the bony prominence close to it. Can you see here? This is the sacral hiatus and it is enclosed on either side by the sacral corona. So that bony prominence give you the hint that we have reached the right location. I would like to give you another diagram which will clear this picture. So everyone, can you see two sacral coronas, one on the right and the other on the left? And this gap, which is well appreciated in this diagram, this gap is the sacral hiatus, which is enclosed on either side by a bony prominence, which is called a sacral corona. This is median sacral crest, which is lying more proximally. It has to be not approached. Also, these sacral foraminas is not has to be approached. We have to approach the bony prominence, that is sacral corona. Okay, let's move on to the next one. So actually, all of you can revise this diagram. You can see this diagram, which is showing you medial sacral crest lying on more proximal aspect, the lateral sacral crest, and also the foraminas. So we have to approach the corona for giving epidural block. Let's move on to the next clinical scenario MCQ. Question number fifth. A 45-year-old woman is admitted to the hospital with difficulty in breathing. Okay, the patient is having difficulty in breathing. Radiological examination reveals a tumor. A tumor is involved, invading the lung surface anterior to the hilum. What is the landmark, anatomical landmark is showing that the tumor is invading anterior to that of hilum. Kya relation hai? Anterior to the hilum. So which nerve is being compressed by the tumor to result in dyspnea? Whether it is phrenic, whether it is vagus, whether it is intercostal, recurrent laryngeal or cardiac plexus. So let's move on to the correct answer. All the best to everyone. Five options are there. Mark the correct answer. क्वेश्चन नंबर फिफ्थ. So good score. We have got 75% students have marked so good score. The correct answer is phrenic nerve. So I would like to show you a diagram. Actually, the more hint which was provided in this clinical scenario MCQ is that the structure is related to the lung hilum and the structure is lying anterior to the hilum of the lung. So in all these options which is provided in this MCQ, we have got phrenic nerve which is lying anterior to the hilum of the lung. So phrenic nerve is the correct answer. Vagus, intercostal, recurrent laryngeal, none of these structure is lying anterior. So all these are not correct. They are actually located more posteriorly and not anterior. So phrenic nerve is the correct answer. I would like to show you a diagram for this which will give you a better picture of relation of the structure in the lung hilum. So all of you, please pay attention to this diagram. So here you can see in this diagram, this is anterior, this is posterior, and the structure which is shown by an oval structure is the hilum. So what you can see, phrenic nerve jo hai, wo hilum of the lung ke anteriorly pass kar raha hai. It is located on the anterior aspect of the hilum of the lung. When you will see the posterior aspect, what you can see, the structure which is traversing, that is the vagus nerve, and we know that recurrent laryngeal nerve is also a branch of vagus nerve. So all these two nerves will be related onto the posterior aspect of hilum. It is related onto the posterior aspect of the hilum, which is very clear from this diagram. Now, my dear friends, also see here, this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve onto the left-hand side, and this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve onto the right-hand side. In the left-hand side, it is forming a loop around arch of aorta, and in the right-hand side, it is forming a loop around right subclavian artery. So yes, this is not a right answer because these are not passing in relation to anterior aspect of hilum. Now, cardiac plexus is again a wrong option. See here, if you will see the location of superficial cardiac plexus, it is lying very close to the arch of aorta and close to that of pulmonary trunk. See here, this is the ligamentum arteriosum and very close to it lies the superficial cardiac plexus, below arch of aorta and close to the bifurcation of pulmonary trunk. If you will see a diagram from deep cardiac plexus, see here, deep cardiac plexus is located at the anterior to bifurcation of trachea. Bifurcation of trachea ke anteriorly deep cardiac plexus hai. So this is also a wrong option. Let's move on to the next one, question number six. A 45-year-old woman is admitted to the outpatient clinic for shoulder pain. During physical examination, she presents with weakened shoulder movements. Radiological examination reveals signs of quadrangular space syndrome. See here, this is the key point which is mentioned, quadrangular space syndrome. Got it? Causing weakened shoulder movement. So which of the following nerve is most likely to be affected? Whether it is suprascapular, whether it is subscapular, whether it is axillary, radial and ulnar. Your time begins now. That is question number six. Please mark the correct answer. Five options are there. Question number six. Mark the correct answer. Okay, good one. Many of the students has given the right answer, and it's a clinical scenario question, but the anatomical landmark is mentioned here. Yahan pe jo anatomical landmark mentioned hai, that gives us a hint to approach to the right answer. Okay, quadrangular space syndrome, actually on the posterior aspect of the scapula, there is one quadrangular space and two triangular spaces. So the structure traversing through this quadrangular space is axillary nerve, along with which artery? कौन सा आर्टरी ट्रैवर्स करता है यहाँ पे? Which one? Posterior circumflex humeral artery. So posterior circumflex humeral artery. Absolutely right. Yeah, Nandini, you are absolutely right. So इस एरिया में posterior circumflex humeral artery along with axillary nerve is traversing. So these are the structures which will be compressed, which will be weakened, and we know that axillary nerve is supplying, giving innervation to deltoid muscle, and deltoid muscle is causing abduction of shoulder joint. Abduction of arm or shoulder joint, that is 15 to 90 degree, actually the acromial fibers, that means axillary nerve is the correct answer. So other options are absolutely wrong. Radial ulnar nerve is lying in relation to posterior and medial aspect of the second part of axillary artery. Suprascapular is related to suprascapular notch of the scapula. Subscapular is a branch of posterior cord of brachial plexus. So all other options are absolutely wrong except the option C. I would like to show you a diagram. So this is a view, which is the posterior aspect of scapula, which is shown here. And this is QS for the quadrangular space. Which two structure yahan se pass karta hai? Axillary nerve and posterior circumflex humeral artery. This is triangular space inferior. Can anybody tell me triangular space inferior se kaun sa structure pass karta hai? Which structure? Radial nerve and an artery, profunda brachii artery. Absolutely right. Profunda brachii artery. And the triangular space superior say only one structure, that is circumflex scapular artery. So this diagram is very helpful for you to revise the boundary. So I'm not telling you about the boundaries because that is actually seen in this image. So slightly on a faster rate, I will go in these MCQ session because it's a revision kind of thing. And I don't want that mere dear students who are the aspirants, their time is get wasted on this particular type. So these are the boundaries. All of you see this diagram, revise the boundaries of quadrangular spaces, triangular spaces, superior and inferior. Got it? Let's move on to the next MCQ, question number 7. Okay. A 22-year-old man is brought into the emergency department following a brawl in tavern. Okay. Ek fight ho gaya. Tavern brawl. Fight in the madhusala, you can say that is the word. He has a severe pain radiating across his back and down to the left upper limb. He supports his left upper limb with right hand, holding it very close to the body. Any attempt to move the left upper limb greatly increases the pain. A radiograph is ordered to reveal the unusual sagittal fracture through the spine of the left scapula. Fracture extended superiorly towards suprascapular notch. So the nerve affected is, all the clinical scenario is approaching towards the correct anatomical landmark. That is the hint which is given. And please mark the correct answer. Your time starts now. Question number 7, please mark the correct answer. Okay, so yes, I have got 33% of the students has given the right answer, 33%. Okay, so my dear friends, what is the correct answer? I will tell you the correct answer here is, the correct answer here is suprascapular nerve. So let me explain this MCQ. Ye itna bada jo clinical aspect, clinical question mein stories bhi bahut hoti, okay? That stories is to target. So you have to just pay attention to the key point. Yahan pe jo key points pointed tha, what was the key point which was pointed? That he has got severe pain in the back and upper limb, and he's holding, means the he's holding his left upper limb with the right arm, and greatly the pain is there, and actually fracture is very close to the spine of left scapula, and it is extending to a region of suprascapular notch. Yes, Manish Kumar Singh is absolutely right. So hame kya karna hai, Arjun ki tarah bas ek point ko mark karna hai. How to answer the clinical question, the key points. Okay, so we have to mark the key points which is mentioned. Ye sara stories ke beech mein aapko keyword was already mentioned here, that is suprascapular notch. So hamara answer kya hona chahiye, the structure that is passing through suprascapular notch and the structure traversing is suprascapular nerve. So the correct answer is suprascapular nerve. I would like to appreciate this by showing you a diagram so that it will be easy for you to revise. So all of you, please see the scapula as shown from the posterior aspect. This is the diagram which is showing the posterior view of the scapula. This is the suprascapular nerve, and ye suprascapular nerve ke upar ek ligament hai, that is suprascapular notch ligament. And all of you can clearly appreciate the nerve which is passing below this structure and going. So yahan pe kaun sa structure fracture hua tha? Spine of the scapula. So you can see spine of the scapula fracture hua, aur uske baad wo fracture line superiorly gaya. Jab wo travel superior direction mein hua, it was getting to affect the nerve which is passing through this notch, that is suprascapular nerve. Here below is the spinoglenoid notch, usse bhi traverse kar raha hai suprascapular nerve. So suprascapular nerve is injured and it will give paralysis to the muscle which it is supplying. Suprascapular nerve is supplying two muscles, supraspinatus and infraspinatus. That means supra and infraspinatus muscle will be paralyzed. Is it okay? Can we move on to the next MCQ, everyone? Yes, let's move on to the next MCQ. That is MCQ number 8. Understood? Question number 8. Okay, let's move on to question number 8. A 6-year-old boy is admitted to the hospital with coughing and dyspnea. What is the presentation? Coughing and dyspnea. During taking the history, he complains that he feels like a glass in his lung. Okay, a feeling of glass in his lung. Auscultation reveals abnormal lung sound. Okay, फिर auscultate किया patient को, तो abnormal lung sound heard. The abnormal lung sound heard is most clearly during the inhalation and with the scapula being protracted. So which of the following form of border of the triangular space and which one of these structure, where is the anatomical landmark where you can hear the lung sounds? So we have got 5 options. Please mark the correct answer. So just go through all the option, read it, take your time and mark the correct answer. Question number 8. So don't worry, please, everyone pay attention. Don't worry, nothing to worry. Okay, everyone. So you can see the screen. Is it okay? Wally, I am not seen. That is not a problem. Okay, so yes, I got many of the students has marked the answer right because the anatomical landmark is mentioned. Okay, anatomical landmark is mentioned. So, okay, anatomy, triangle of auscultation, absolutely right, absolutely right, absolutely right. Yeah, triangle of auscultation is the correct answer. And in this question, we know that the triangle of auscultation ka boundaries hai, latissimus dorsi, the trapezius and the medial border of the scapula. Got it? So question number 8, the correct answer is latissimus dorsi, trapezius, medial border of scapula. Is it okay, everyone? So all other option is absolutely wrong. And don't worry, each of this option, which triangular space it is forming, I will show you with the help of diagrams. Okay, so let's see few diagrams. Okay, let's see few diagrams, which is always asked as an MCQ. Okay, let me show you that diagram. So firstly, I would like to show you the triangular gap space. Can you see here? This triangular gap space, so which I am highlighting here, this triangular space which you are seeing here, this triangular space is the triangle of auscultation. So this is actually used for hearing the breath sound because it is not covered by important muscles. So it is bounded by trapezius muscle. Okay, on the as you can see here, more medially, latissimus dorsi inferiorly, and also medial border of scapula. So these are the three structures which is forming the boundaries for triangle of auscultation. Medial border of scapula will be covered by rhomboidus group of muscle. Okay, so trapezius, medial border of scapula, and the latissimus dorsi. These are the structure which is forming the boundary for triangle of auscultation. Got it? So this is the right answer. I would like to show you another diagram here. So all of you, please focus here. This is the lumbar triangle, which was also given in the option. And do revise the boundaries of lumbar triangle. So boundaries of lumbar triangle is, it is bounded by the iliac crest below. Okay, it is bounded by iliac crest below, latissimus dorsi and external oblique muscle. LD, latissimus dorsi, external oblique muscle, and the iliac crest. Okay, iliac crest, that is the superior border of hip bone. These three structures are forming the boundary for which triangle, my dear friends? Lumbar triangle. What is the other name? Lumbar triangle is also called as Pittet's triangle. What is its important? It's important is that this is a area of weakness, muscular weakness. The floor of this triangular space is formed by internal oblique muscle. Floor of this triangular space is formed by internal oblique muscle. This is an area of muscular weakness, and this is an area for herniation, lumbar herniation. Now we have already done this. This is lower lumbar herniation area, lumbar triangle, which we have already seen, lumbar triangle. Let me tell you about the boundaries of superior lumbar triangle. So when you will see superior lumbar triangle, it is bounded by 12th rib, okay, and by internal oblique muscle and by quadratus lumborum. See here, 12th rib, internal oblique muscle, quadratus lumborum muscle, this together forms this triangular space, which is called as superior lumbar triangle. Again, an area of weakness where lumbar herniation occurs. Now, I want to show you a green color structure here. This is called as Which triangle? Hasselbalch triangle. Hasselbalch inguinal triangle. This is bounded by rectus abdominis muscle, inferior epigastric vessel, and lower down it is bounded by inguinal ligament. This is the area of weakness. And which herniation occurs through this area of weakness? Direct or indirect herniation? Anyone? Hassel triangle or inguinal triangle is weakness of direct herniation. Absolutely right. It's a weakness of direct herniation. Let's move on to the next MCQ. I think it is okay. Let's move on to the next MCQ. MCQ number 9. Pre-traumatic nerve of first arch. What is the correct answer? Question number 9. Pre-traumatic nerve of the first arch. Whether it is mandibular, trisominal, glossopharyngeal, caudate, tympanic. Your time starts now. So yes, we have got 32% of the students are right, 34%, great one. We have got 34%. Nandini is leading, followed by Manish Kumar Raj. Okay, great. The correct answer, pre-traumatic nerve of the first arch. The correct answer is caudate tympanic nerve. Okay, caudate tympanic nerve. Yes. Actually, there is two types of nerves, pre-traumatic and post-traumatic. That is related to that of caudal and the cranial border of pharyngeal arches. So in case of human beings, the pre-traumatic nerve is not there, only the first arch. Okay, some of the authors tell that second arch, third arch, maybe hamare paas hai, tympanic branch of the glossopharyngeal nerve is treated as pre-traumatic nerve. But if we will see most of the books, only first arch is having pre-traumatic nerve and caudate tympanic nerve is the right answer. So caudate tympanic nerve is considered to be pre-traumatic branch of first arch. So only tongue ke anterior sensation, tongue anterior part developed from first arch, and it is getting innervation from first arch nerve, that is pre-traumatic taste sensation, that is caudate tympanic nerve. I would like to show you a diagram. See here, this is first arch, this is second arch, this is third arch. Okay, so each arch is having one post-traumatic nerve. So a post-traumatic nerve is running on cranial border. Ye kaun sa border hai? Cranial border. Ye kaun sa border hai first arch ka? Caudal border. So cranial border ke paas kaun sa nerve run kar raha hai? Mandibular nerve. Mandibular nerve is a branch of trisominal nerve. So it is post-traumatic branch of first arch. My dear friends, just see the caudal border. If you will see the caudal border, you have got caudate tympanic nerve, and caudate tympanic nerve is considered to be pre-traumatic nerve of first arch. Is it okay, everyone? It is considered to be pre-traumatic nerve of the first arch. Let's move on to the next MCQ, that is MCQ number 10. Okay, identify the histological slide. Okay, whether it is spleen, lymph node, ileum of thymus. Your time starts now. Question number 10. So yes, I have got 50% students, I think, has given the right answer. So at the end, I will show you the leaderboard. We have got 5 more MCQs, okay? And then I have to start another session, the third part of MCQ series. The correct answer is lymph node. I will tell you why it is lymph node. Many of you have given the right answer. So this is a slide of lymph node. And the reason is that, see here. Here, this is lymphatic aggregation. This is lymphatic follicle, okay? This is lymphatic follicle. This is GC, germinal center. This is the fibrous capsule. And this space is subcapsular space. Subcapsular sinus or space. So subcapsular sinus or space is the key factor which is present in the slide of lymph node along with lymphatic follicle aggregates. These are trabeculase. Okay, these are trabeculase. And you can see lymphatic follicle, fibrous capsule, subcapsular sinus, and the lymphatic follicle having GC. This is the slide of lymph node. This part is the medulla. Okay, this outer part is the cortex. So this is a slide of lymph node. This clears that this is a slide of lymph node. So the correct answer is lymph node. It is not ileum. Why? Because agar ye slide ileum ka hota, to 4 layers of GIT will be there. Thymus nahi hai because absence of corpus, Hassel corpuses. Agar Hassel corpuses दिखता देन इट वुड बी अ स्लाइड ऑफ थाइमस. स्प्लीन नहीं है क्योंकि व्हाइट पल्प और रेड पल्प दिखना चाहिए था. अगर स्प्लीन होता तो व्हाइट पल्प और रेड पल्प होता और ईसेंट्रिक लोकेशन ऑफ द सेंट्रल आर्टरी होता. सो दिस इज अ स्लाइड ऑफ लिम्फ नोड. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. ओके, आइडेंटिफाई द हिस्टोलॉजिकल स्लाइड. Identify the histological slide whether it is thick skin, ileum, duodenum or thin skin. Four options are there. Please mark the correct answer. Your time starts now. So yes, we have got approximately 38% students are correct. So let me give you the key points. कैसे हम identify करेंगे? Thick skin तो नहीं है. Correct answer thin skin. Thick skin नहीं है. Why? No keratinization. No keratinization is there. Keratinized नहीं है. And actually and also what you can see the major point I will tell you better option के लिए the key point it is not there because thick skin इसमें क्या है? इसमें आपको sebaceous gland मिलता है. Sebaceous gland is shown there and there is hair follicle. So these all hair follicles, sebaceous gland, sweat gland, so as you can see here, these are hair follicles. Okay, this is hair follicles, this is sebaceous gland, this is sebaceous gland which is shown, and here you can see this part is the erector pylorum muscle, erector pylorum muscle. So this is a slide of thin skin. थिक स्किन में आपको हेयर फॉलिकल, सेबिशियस ग्लैंड ये सारे स्ट्रक्चर्स नहीं एविडेंट होंगे. ओके, एंड वेरी थिक लेयर ऑफ केराटिनाइजेशन होगा. बहुत मोटा केराटिनाइज्ड लेयर होगा. मोटा कॉर्नियम बहुत थिक होगा और बहुत केराटिनाइजेशन होगा. इलियम और डियोडिनम नो रीजन टू गेट कंफ्यूज बिकॉज फोर लेयर्स ऑफ जीआईटी विल बी देयर. लाइनिंग एपिथेलियम विल बी, इट इज स्ट्रेटिस्फाइड. दिस इज स्ट्रेटिस्फाइड. यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज स्ट्रेटिस्फाइड एपिथेलियम है ना. It is stratified epithelium. Okay, keratinized stratified epithelium, which is not the lining epithelium of ileum or duodenum. अगर ileum or duodenum का slide है, तो वो columnar epithelium होगा. Columnar epithelium. So this is a slide of thin skin. Got it? Let's move on to question number 12. A 21-year-old woman is admitted to the hospital with a pain radiating from her lower back towards the pubic symphysis. A kidney stone is suspected and ultrasound reveals a stone partially obstructing the lower part of her right ureter. The stone is probably lodged where the ureter crosses which structure? So please give the answer. You have to know the relations of ureter and you will approach to the correct answer. So here time starts now. Whether it is inferior vena cava, whether it is internal iliac artery, common iliac artery, fourth lumbar artery or inferior mesenteric artery. Question number 12, mark the correct answer. So yes, 39% students are correct. Actually, the hint which is provided in this MCQ is that kidney stone, जब हम suspect कर रहे हैं, तो ultrasound में stone is partially obstructing lower part of right ureter and it crosses which structure? Actually, that means you have to know the relation of ureter posteriorly. So we know that bifurcation of common iliac artery is the area of constriction of ureter. We have got three areas of constriction of ureter. Ek hai pelvi-uretric junction, ek hai bifurcation of common iliac artery, and the third one is vesico-uretric junction. Vesico-uretric junction means when the ureter is opening into urinary bladder. So along the option provided, C is the correct answer. Common iliac artery bifurcation. See here, this is common iliac artery bifurcation and you can see it is related at the level of pelvic brim and it is related with the ureter at the lower aspect. So this is the correct option. Is it okay, everyone? It's okay, everyone? Can we move on to next MCQ? Question number 13. Okay. All of the following arteries of the pelvis are branches of internal iliac artery except. Question number 13. All of the following arteries of the pelvis are branches of internal iliac artery except. Easy one. So yes, we have got, okay, what happened? Okay, all of the following are the branches of internal iliac except. So ovarian is the correct answer. Ovarian is a branch of abdominal aorta. Actually, all the gonadal arteries, ovarian and testicular arteries, are direct branches of abdominal aorta. Umbilical artery, uterine artery, this is not the right answer, because vaginal, uterine, umbilical is the branches of anterior division of internal iliac artery. These are the branches of anterior division of internal iliac artery. Question number 13. Okay, let's see here. Now, this is the diagram in which you can see the branches of internal iliac artery. So those who have made a mistake, do revise the branches of internal iliac artery. Here, the branches of anterior division, obliterated umbilical artery, superior vesical artery, obturator artery, vaginal artery, uterine artery, middle rectal, internal pudendal, and inferior gluteal. If we talk about posterior division, three branches from the anterior, from the internal iliac artery, posterior division. Okay, iske posterior division se three branches hai, iliolumbar, lateral sacral, and superior gluteal. So all of you do revise the branches of internal iliac artery. I would like to show you an another diagram where you can see the branches also. So see here, ovarian artery is the correct answer. It's not a branch of internal iliac artery, it's a branch of aorta, abdominal aorta. It's a branch of abdominal aorta. So this is the correct answer. So now let's move to question number 14. Don't worry, those who have joined late also, I will give you 15 minutes of break, and again I will join at, so it will be hardly 10 minutes break only, I think 10 minutes ka break hoga, and then I will start the session from 9 p.m. 9. Okay, so superficial muscle fibers of external oblique muscle interdigitate with which of the following muscle? Very easy, mark your answer. Question number 14. So yes, we have got 39% students are correct, and the correct answer is external oblique muscle interdigitate with serratus anterior muscle fibers. Okay, let me show you a diagram. Can you see here, this muscle which you are seeing here, this is EO, external oblique muscle, and these digitations with which it is intermingling, this is serratus anterior muscle. Lower down also latissimus dorsi muscle. So yes, the correct answer is interdigitation of external oblique muscle fibers is with serratus anterior muscle. Got it? Let's move on to the next question, question number 15. Which of the following nerves do not innervate scrotum? Among the five options provided, which of the following nerve is not a nerve supply for the scrotum? Your time begins now. Question number 15, please mark the correct answer. Question number 15. So yes, we have got 25% students has marked it right. Obturator nerve is the correct answer. Actually, obturator nerve is not forming any kind of innervation for the scrotum. Rest all nerves is innervating the scrotum. Let me show you a diagram for it. Okay. So everyone, can you see this diagram? See here. The diagram is showing, you can see ilioinguinal nerve, genitogenital, genital branch of genitofemoral, posterior scrotal, and perineal branch of posterior cutaneous nerve. All these are innervating, but not the obturator nerve. So before ending the session, this is my unlock code. Use this for taking the subscription of Unacademy, getting 10% discount. So this is my group. Join for the links of my session. Again, after 10 minutes of gap, I'm starting from 9 p.m. Join the third part of MCQ session. Okay, this will go in continuation. So again, 9 p.m. I'm starting. See here, abhi third part hum start karenge 9 p.m. se. Tomorrow, four parts are there. Again on the Sunday, starting from 10 a.m. So all of you, please note down this. This is the unlock code ENACT10. This is Telegram group of mine. Take the subscription by using the code ENACT10 using 10% discount. 21st July is the date on which I'm starting the whole anatomy course. Extremely beneficial for the next aspirants, and that for first year prof. All the first year subject will be completed for clearing your university prof examination. Join it, okay? And anyone can take 4 year subscription by using my code ENACT10, okay? And this is the comparison of Plus and that of Iconic subscription. All the best. Keep studying. So all of you, can join me again. Take 10 minutes of break and join me 9 p.m. session. I'm starting in 10 minutes. All the best. Thank you.